set, I think we're up and going.
We're recording now.
Please stand.
Dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord
Peter proceeded to address the people in these words. In truth, I say that God shows no partiality. Rather than in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him. You know the word that he said to the Israelites as he proclaimed peace for Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. He commenced to us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by the judge, God is judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness, and everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of the sins through his name, the word of the Lord.
Please stand. Let the Lord be with you. A reading now from the Holy Gospel according to John. So Jesus told his disciples, "The hour has come the Son of Man be glorified, and I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. If it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it. Whoever hates his life in this world preserves it for life eternal. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me." And this is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Be seated for a moment. As we come here this morning, I want to extend once again to all of our raised family, certainly our deepest support, prayers, and sympathy at the loss of her wonderful lady, and very dedicated to her family, to her church, to her community. And so there's certainly the grief and the tears that you feel at this particular moment. But we're lucky that, and fortunate that we can also, like Irene, have the gift of faith. A faith that got her through so many good moments and bad moments in her life. And a faith that tells us today that Jesus is there to give us hope and resurrection and overcome death itself. And so in the midst of the grief that you feel, I ask to hold on to that wonderful gift of faith, again, that gives us the hope that only God can give. I often like to quote at funerals what the French painter Henri Matisse said prior to his death in 1954. Of course, we know Matisse as a very famous painter. His paintings are invaluable today. But he was also crippled at the end of his life with very painful arthritis, moving his hands and his fingers. But he kept on painting, and then, no matter how bad the pain was. And somebody asked him one day, "Why do you submit your body to such pain?" He said this, he said, "The pain is going to pass eventually, but the beauty will always remain. The pain passes, but the beauty remains." And I couldn't help but think of Irene today, that any pain or suffering, you know, difficulty she had, especially in the last couple of years, that's gone. But what remains is the beauty of her life, the beauty of all of you here today, you know, celebrating her life and her love, and the beauty that she left each one of us as a very dedicated, faithful parishioner, above all in our community. So today I think we begin by remembering those moments of love and beauty that were part of Irene's 86 years. 86 years old, a loving wife to her late husband Charles, a loving mother and sister and grandmother and aunt and friend and family member. She was born not too far away in Holyoke, October 30, 1934. Grew up there, eventually made her way to New York, and then eventually back here in Connecticut. And proudly served the Connecticut Air National Guard for 31 years. That was, I'm sure, mind-blowing to people of that age, for 31 years to be in the Air Guard, especially for a woman. She broke the barrier, thank God. She loved to ski in her younger days, to sing and play cards, and of course bingo. Very active in the Windsor Locks Senior Center, and loved to get to her winter home in Florida. As the picture showed at the wake last night, very lively individual. I think I mentioned the family yesterday. I'd love to have met her in her heyday. I bet she was a non-stop person. I said yesterday, definitely a character in a good sense. And she continued that all through her life. What struck me too was her spirit. She went through a lot of tragedy in life, needless to say, and yet rebounding from that. It was, I think, her spirit, her faith, her trust, her love for life that allowed her to do that. Great example for you, would be. But friendly, outgoing person, hope and optimism, no matter what hardships she faced. Other memories you have of her, like the pictures last night of the wake, hold on to them because no one can take them away. They're truly gifts of God. Also, I mentioned we are grateful for the gift of faith. Faith began 86 years ago, probably in the Church of Holyoke, where Irene was baptized. And that baptism marked her as a child of God and gave her, like each one of us, the promise of life eternal. The symbols we have at every funeral would be similar to the symbols at a baptism, and that's done intentionally. The large candle here called the Easter candle, a similar one would have been present at her baptism. And the godparents would get small candles taken from the big candle with the following prayer. May the light of this candle burn brightly. May it guide you every step of your way. And so before Irene, those 86 years, good days and bad days, the light of that candle guided her to this very moment. Well, the covering on the casket is white, symbolizing the baptismal garment put on her as a baby. With the words of St. Paul, put on your faith as you would a garment, never take it off. And certainly, that faith was part and parcel of her life. Not just here, but also at church. Every Sunday when she felt good, she was here. That was part of her religion and her faith. And of course, the holy water I sprinkled on her as she came in today, reminding us of the waters of baptism that poured over her head as a baby, claiming her as a child of God and promising her this very day the gift of life eternal. The gospel I chose today speaks also, too, of hope after life, after death. And Jesus compared death to that of a seed going in the ground. And unless you bury a seed and lose it for a while, it's not going to grow. In the same way, he said, we too must die physically before we can come to the fullness of what God wants us to be. Fullness of life eternal. So today we come together to thank God for the gift of Irene's life and her dedication, but also we thank God for the gift of faith that was part and parcel of her life. And our prayer today is that faith, which began 86 years ago, now brings her to the wonderful gift of life eternal. And a little poem that I'd like to share is entitled, I'm Free. And these might be Irene's words to all of you today, and it goes like this. Don't grieve for me, because now I'm free. I am following the path God laid out for me. I took his hand when I heard him call. I could not turn my back and left it all. I could not stay another day to laugh, to love, to work, or play. For tasks left undone must stay that way. I found peace in the close of the day. If my parting has left a void, then fill it with remembered joy. A friendship shared, a laugh, a kiss, yes, these things I too will miss. But be not burdened with times of sorrow, I wish you the sunshine of tomorrow. My life has been full, I savored much, good friends, good times, and a loved one's touch. Perhaps my time seemed all too brief, but don't lengthen it now with undue grief. Lift up your heart and share with me, for God wanted me now, he has set me free. Today, may Irene, after a life well lived, be greeted by the saints and angels to the glory of heaven. We stand now for our prayer. And our response now will be, Lord, hear our prayer. So, loving God, we turn to you today. Today, may you greet your servant Irene into the wonderful life of eternity. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for her family and friends here this morning, that God will continue to bless you with peace and safety and health, and above all the gift of faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Irene served in the military for 31 years. Let us pray today for all military personnel throughout the world. For their safety and their protection, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we pray for those less fortunate than you or I, the hungry, the unemployed, the homeless, the destitute, the addicted, the terminally ill, that our Christian response can alleviate their pain or suffering, we pray to the Lord. And for the departed family members of Irene, that they too today share the gift of life eternal, we pray to the Lord. And now in the silence of our heart, we have our own intentions. So loving God and Father, we turn to you today. May the words of Scripture, the Eucharist that we share, lead us someday to that gift of life eternal. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth.
the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel. Lord, you are holy indeed. You are the fountain of holiness. Make holy the gifts we bring by sending down your Holy Spirit upon them, so they can become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, began his passion, he took bread. He blessed it, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up." In the same way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and drink of this, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And together now we proclaim this mystery. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. As we now celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks for both us worthy to be in your presence and serve you. Humbly we pray as we partake of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. And Lord, we pray for your church throughout the world. Bring in the fullness of charity with Francis, our Pope, Leonard, our Bishop, your clergy, and all your faithful people. Today, remember your servant Irene, whom you call from this world to yourself. Grant that she may be united now with your Son in the gift of heaven. Also, we pray for many other brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy, welcome them into your presence. And have mercy on us, we pray, that with Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus, our living Savior. For it is through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. You stand. And now, praying with faith and confidence, we turn to our loving God as we pray in the words that Jesus gave to us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, deliver us from every evil, grant peace in our day. By the help of your mercy, keep us free from sin, safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours. And Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, we will live forever and ever." And may God's peace be with all. And we've said to each other now, a sign or a wave of God's peace. Word in my soul. down the center and return away to sideways. Let us pray for standing. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sap of his body, food for the journey, mercy grant the strength and by it, our sister Irene, become the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please remain standing now for our final words. Before we go our separate ways, now we take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her, may ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. For one day we shall joyfully meet her again, when Christ's love conquers all things, destroys even death itself. So saints of God, now come to her aid. Come to meet her, all you angels. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take it to himself. May angels lead you to the heart of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant to her, O Lord, the perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul and present her to God, O Most High. Into your hands, Father, mercies, we commend our sister Irene, in the sure and certain hope that together with all have died in Christ, to rise with him on the last day. We thank you for all the blessings you gave her in this life. They are signs for us of your goodness and our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us, listen to our prayers, open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us to remain to comfort one another with the assurance of faith. And we all meet in Christ, our you and our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And so may the angels lead you to paradise, Irene. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the heart of Abraham. And where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. Amen. And there will be military honors inside, outside. Be outside.
States Air Force and the great nation. Please accept this flag as a symbol of our community, for love, honor,